So till now we have completed this thing, right? So now let's focus on another part of the video, okay? And it means we have to create this server, okay? So for that I'm going to use Google, and let's create here. So just type your scale drone, okay, and open this website, real-time messaging service, and I'm going to click on create account option, okay? And then we need to sign up into this account. So I'm using your temp email address to sign up, okay? So go to here, change email address, and then your password is something, and I'm not a robot, and by sign up and click on sign up. Alright, so after creating account you will see the option of create channel. So click on that create channel, and your channel name is video calling app, okay, and authentication is never, and click on create channel. That's your channel ID and that's the secret key. Now I have two files. I will give you the link of both files, okay? So open this script.js file, okay, and you can open this in Notepad or VS Code, anywhere, okay? And let's put that channel ID here and scroll down, and you will find the channel ID option. Scroll down and you can just search here channel ID. You'll see your channel ID, right? So that's the channel ID we have to replace. So copy this from here and go to here and then paste it, right? Simple, and command S or control S, and we don't need to do anything here, right? We don't need to paste secret here, okay? So let's close this. All right, now our file code is completed. If you want to change the some code for like for view, okay, so you need to change on that index file, okay? I have completed this file with the mobile version, okay, with I have completed this as a responsive site. You, if you want to change the background, if you want to change something here, so you can do this with that code, HTML code or CSS code, right? So it's the HTML file, simple. Its extension is PHP, okay, but it's the overall HTML and CSS code, okay? Now let's, that's the file completed. Now we have to open another account. It's for free hosting. So I'm using here 000 web host, okay? That is very popular website to create a free PHP hosting, right? So click on free PHP hosting, or you can open just simply webhost.com website, and we have to create account here. Let's click on this free sign up, and I'm going to log in with my Google account. Now here you can see, you can see it's not my first show. Take me the panel, okay? And you can see website name is optional, so you can say this video calling app, okay? And just click on that. You can see generate password, okay, and click on submit, and you can see upload your site. So click on that select, and we have to upload both files here that we have done, okay? Here both file, open this public HTML folder and upload both file here, okay? So drag and drop that both file here, try to do this, yes, and upload. Finally file is uploaded. Now go to the video calling app, you can see, and go to the main page here, and you'll find here that's the URL, okay? Just open this URL, this one, right? Now let me just off this, okay? No, I'm not allowing. Okay, just copy this one URL, not this code, okay? Copy this URL only and just close this, okay? Now we need to code for the app, okay? So that is the complete process for creating the hosting, free hosting, and scale drone ID. Now let's move to the MIT App Inventor app, right? Now here go to the design, and you will find the text box. So which text box? Hide this vertical arrangement and open vertical arrangement 2, and in that text box, it means which one? This one is text box 2, to paste here that text like this. So whenever someone open our app, whenever someone click on the create account, so automatically this should be open, okay? And this will automatically generate one ID here. So whenever I click on that share ID, so we need to just get that ID only, right? So let's go to the block and let's do some more code. So the custom web view page loaded, okay? So click on that custom web view and you will find your page loaded option method page loaded, okay? Drag and drop it here like this, and on that here we need to call set text box 2. Okay, so you'll find here text box 2, this one, text box 2 dot text. This here, text box 2 dot text should be joined with. Okay, so click on that text, you'll find join option, this one here, and in that we need to get the custom web view dot current URL. Okay, so click on that custom web view and you will find the current URL, this one, current URL here. And then second thing, we need to get the text box 2.1 dot text data. Text data, okay, it means whenever someone open the page load. Okay, so if I will put here, let me just show you how it's work. Okay, and let me just, if I just put here some ID, okay, for joining. So if I will click on that join button, okay, so whenever someone open that app and whenever someone open the browser, so this will connect with the code. Okay, so which code we have to connect it? The text box 1 dot text. So you will find text box 1 dot text, this one. We will combine both like this. Okay, now let's code for whenever a screen will in a slide. Let's open the, click on the screen, and you'll find here whenever a screen will in a slice, this one. Okay, so let me just code here, this one. Whenever a screen will in a slice, we need to create the web view. Okay, we will create this web view dynamically, right? So you can see the option of call create web view. Create web view option, create web view. Here you'll find this one, create web view, and the container. So which container, in which container we have to create? So hide this one visible off, or you can make visible on this one, vertical arrangement 3. Okay, so go to the block vertical arrangement 3 and just select this one. Okay, and the ID you can make anything, right? So I just put, suppose here anything like maths is 11, but remember this 11. Okay, on that. And the second thing, we need to set web view for that ID, right? So for that, just simply go to the custom web view and you need to find set web view. Set, you can see the PQRS, right? Set web view ID, right? All are coded defined via the alphabets. So set web view ID should be 7 that we have defined, because we have created that web viewer, right? In the dynamic value, right? So this should be also 7, right? Now in the last, we have to use your go to URL option. So just again, custom web view, go to URL means G, so P is G, go to URL, this one. So call it here, and the URL, which one? The URL should be this one, and that one is text box 2. So go to the block and text box 2 dot text, here you will find it here. This one. Now we need to whenever someone, this one is for whenever someone want to create the ID. Okay, whenever someone want to create the meeting, so now they have created the meeting, now they have to share that ID. Okay, so there's two options. If someone share the ID, so we can share the only ID, so they have to join with the app is compulsory, but we can share the whole URL. It means whenever I create the ID, or whenever I create the meeting ID from my app, so someone can join with their browser also, like in a Zoom. Okay, we can create the ID from the app, but anyone can join that that Zoom link, that joined with the Zoom link in the browser, in the desktop. They don't need the Apple, they don't need the Zoom app. Okay, they can join using browser. So like we can do like that. Or you can hide that one part. You don't need this part. You can just simply hide this. Okay, like if you don't want to display that URL, so you can simply hide it. Go to the hide this one also like this, and go to the block. All right, now we have to whenever someone click on that button to join button. Okay, it means this one button 1. So we have to clear the cache. So for the browser, so click on button 1, whenever someone click on button 1, it means this one. So first we will clear the cache. So custom web view dot clear cache. Okay, like this. Okay, we have already have used this one, I think, here, button 1 option. Let me just delete this. cancel. So now let's you can see button 1. So I will use your clear cache option in the front. Okay, and then I have to use this one option again. Go to URL, this one, simply, right, and on the button 1 click, right, and on the button 3 click, we are just going to use your button, the go to URL option, simply. And we don't need it also, because whenever someone open this app, so they just need to click on that create meeting option. But sometimes we have to create 2 meetings, suppose. Okay, so what I will do, so that's why we have to use some more code to click on that button. So whenever someone click on that button, it means button 2. So we have to code for that. So we need to just copy paste that code, simple as like here, that we have done in the button 1. First we will clear the cache, right, like this, and then we will use your go to URL option. We can say simple go to URL option, but here we need to change something. And then what we need to change, here simple, not this one, we will use your join option, or you will find click on join, and we already have completed this thing, I think. Here no, we have to click on text join, this one. Okay, and then we have to add our string here, and which string we have to add, we know that, or that one link, where is our backside link, this one, this copy link. Okay, and the second, we need to use text box too. Right now, whenever someone click on that share ID button, so we don't need to share that whole URL to anyone. Okay, we can just share that the dynamic value of that ID. Okay, so how we can do that? So simply, so whenever someone click on that share ID, it means just hide this one, make it visible on, and you can see that button name is button 4. Okay, so go to the blog. So on button 4 click, it means on that button 4 click. Okay, so let me just make it here. Oh, sorry, a lot of code here. I will give you the AI file of that. Okay, no problem, don't worry. On that button 4 click, we have to share. So we need here one more component, is share component. So go to the media option. No, I think in the social option, yes. And drag and drop this share option here. Go to the block again. Click on that sharing, and sharing message, this one, call it here, and the message, and which message we have to share. So we have to replace all the string, and we have to just get the code only. Okay, code. So how we can get that code or ID of that video call? So simple, we need to call here that one function, current web URL, right? But for that we need to replace the text. Okay, so click on text, and you will find your replace all text, this one, from the current URL, and the which segment we have to replace. So we have to replace the some particular text, and that text is this one, copy here, it means your URL, right? And remaining text should be our ID. Okay, so we have to replace this one, should from nothing, like this, right? Now we have remaining only code, also code only, right? So we will share that code on that button click, right? We can share that code anywhere, like in a WhatsApp, in an email, anywhere, right? And we have to learn code for back button also. It means button 3 is our back button, right, this one. So on that we have to make it you can say it's a false. So we will make this one vertical arrangement should be true, vertical should be true, okay, visible should be true, but the vertical arrangement should be false to make it false on the back button click. Okay, all right, go to the design and hide this vertical arrangement 2 from here. Okay, and make it vertical arrangement should be visible, like this. Click on that text box, and you can see hint box. You can just simply say the meeting id, right? Now suppose someone don't have that the app, so they don't need to worry. If you want to share that You can remove that replacement option like from here. If you will just share that the URL, current URL only, if I will say suppose here, if I will say share the current URL, okay, then what will happen? We can share that whole URL plus ID. Okay, so in that case, anyone can join with the any browser. They don't need the app also, right? So that's the overall app. Okay, so yes, that's all about it. If you have some doubt, you can ask me on comment, and I will make another one more video on video calling app where I will show you how you can download the GIF file, how you can add the all that things. Okay, and you can create this app in 5 minutes. If you don't want to understand all the things, so don't worry, I will make another video for only 5 minutes, so you can create this app in 5 minutes. You need to download all files and implement it simply. You don't need to do anything, right? So thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.